Welcome back to Sunday Morning Quickies, episode 67 for January 8th, 2023.
We threw him a curveball.
Yes, we did.
Okay. Well, I had a phone call this afternoon, or early this evening, late this afternoon. You know, I just looked at the clock up on the wall in here, and it says 3:28, and it's actually 6:31.
That's because it said exactly the same thing for a long time, and the second hand is
still moving
around and around.
I think we need to do something with that.
Garbage.
No, not necessarily. I like the clock. I just don't like the fact that the hands don't
work.
All the hands except the second hand on that clock are frozen in time. Yeah. That is very, very bizarre. Let's start this again, shall we? Well, that was an interesting curveball.
Yeah, it was fun.
This afternoon, I had a call from Louise, who you might remember from a couple of months ago. I did a video for her about her 285K.
No.
No? J.
Yes.
285J. I'm sorry, Louise. It's a 285J. I am the unfortunate recipient of two 285Ks. Okay. Regardless, it's a 285. Anyway, she called. She was in the neighborhood. We chit-chatted for a while. And she needs a new belt for her machine. And I advised her, I said, you know, ordering a belt by model number can be a fool's errand, although I didn't quite put it that way.
No, you didn't.
But it can be, because a lot of times, a lot of retailers, let me put it this way, a lot of third-party manufacturers will say, oh, this machine needs X size belt, and they are so far from being correct, it is pathetic. So, I promised Louise that I would, because it's really, in this case, it's a two-person operation, because I can't chew gum and walk at the same time, and I had to hold something, so Liz had to do some work. So you'll see, Liz is helping out. I'm putting Liz to work. Dagnabbit. Anyway, we're going to show you the method that we use, anyway, to measure for a belt. Now, like I said, we don't have a 285J. We have 285K. Shouldn't matter. And anyway, so this is going to be the shortest Sunday Morning Quickies ever. So, enjoy. I don't have a 285J like Louise, but I do have not one, but two 285Ks. Yeah, I'm a lucky kind of guy. And I have the lovely and talented Elizabeth standing by, who is going to use her penmanship skills with a gel marker to assist in this process. Now, before we start anything, make sure that your motor mount is adjusted to pretty much the middle of the travel. That way you're going to be able to have a little bit of fudge factor on the length of your belt. We will start by removing the stop motion knob and washer. And I'm going to get this abomination that Singer calls a stretch belt. Woohoo! Oh, so very professional. Get that off the machine. Now, we're going to use some butcher's cord. Everybody's got this, or should have this, in their kitchen drawer somewhere. And we'll take a length that is more than adequate. That's more than adequate. We'll give it the old snippy, snip, snip. Now, I'm going to put this around, going through the pulleys. So now this is up against each other and in the pulleys. Elizabeth is going to make a mark on each end of that, nice and bold so we can see it. Ah, she's got much better penmanship than I do. All right, let's get this professional's choice out of the way. And Liz, would you be so kind? Let's get there. We got our marks up. All right, we take out a tape measure. And I'm going to put the mark that Liz made at the 1-inch mark here. And we'll continue over. It goes directly to 13. So what's 1 from 13? That would be what? 12. So we're looking for a 12-inch belt for this fantastic singer, 285K. Once again, a tailor shop standard all around the world. Do you notice the sarcasm?
I was going to say, what started the snark on this one?
Okay. I don't know if I've got a 12-inch belt, but if I do, I will put a 12-inch on it rather than this abomination. But what I will do for Louise when I am editing this, if I don't have one, I will at least find a source for one and put it in the doobly-doo down below. Well, wonders never cease. I happen to have a lug-style belt that fits this machine. This one actually measures at about 12 and 5/8, which we measured with the string, the bottom of the lands at 12. That's with the adjustment for the motor mount, dead nuts in the middle. We put this on. It does fit. Motors have a little bit of leeway for adjustment, so that's fine. I'm going to put the link down below. Selling Parts Online has these belts. They say they have them in stock. They list a 12, a 12 and a quarter, and a 12 and 5/8, which is probably, might be where I got this one. I don't know. But anyway, so yeah, that's how you measure it. And just remember, make sure that the motor adjustment is dead nuts in the middle or pretty dang close to it. Run your string through both pulleys and get your lovely and charming assistant to make the mark on the string for you.
Hey, Brat Queen.
This is what we put up with, or what Liz puts up with constantly. This is Laverne. Laverne is, what, 4 years old now?
Coming up on 5, I think.
Coming up on 5. She is a shoulder vulture.
And a drooler.
And a drooler. And every time she shakes her head, drool flies all over the place. But she is a sweetie. Anyway, that's what we got for you this week. Shortest Sunday morning quickies ever. Oh, yes, you're such a good girl. Thanks for watching. And it'll be interesting to see how many holes Laverne's claws puts in Liz's shoulders.
I clipped.
You clipped? Very good. See you on the next one.
Take care. Laverne, what are you doing?